Getting them ready for the future. Do you see sustainability being, the ability of an educationist to make sustainability part of a module which can be taught to students to apply it also in practical terms?
See, as a teacher, I touch future. That's what I say. So when I say I touch future, I am creating people who would look at what would be the importance of them to survive in tomorrow's environment. One aspect which I tell them is that you don't know, the future is uncertain. You don't know what kind of jobs you would be coming up with. And especially as a culinary students, the important aspects of food, food security and food sustainability are very critical for them. So if they are going to be trained culinarians, which are going to shape a variety of businesses, not just being a chef, but as an entrepreneur, as a food blogger or a food journalist or a food photographer, they all need to understand the sustainability factor and the security factor behind it. So, as a course, the Symbiosis gives us a lot of freedom into designing what would be the futuristic role of these. And that's how this culinary school has come up. Not for today's requirements, but for next 10, 20, 50, 30 years. And that's what we are designing the program as. And we take inputs regularly from the industry and all stakeholders. One of the aspects which we have included is about the environmental sustainability, which is environmental studies we have put in, where it covers about the water shortage, water pollution, soil and the agriculture part of it, as well as the ecology of food and food security, the systems of it. So that apart from being taught in theory aspects, we also teach into the practical aspects of it, taking the students into a different array of environmental fields, including the farming community, as well as the trading community who does the trading. So basically the entire cycle of food security there, from right from sowing and growing to consumer and end consumer as well. So one of the aspects of our course curriculum, which I was just talking a little while ago, is about them to go and explore about the regional Indian food, which has yet been very unexplored. And as an educationist, it's my duty and my responsibility to ask the students to go and explore it. So what we have is a local immersion program where students generally go to various interiors in communities, local communities, sit with them, talk with them, live with them for a period of a week or so, and come out with their learning and understanding of food, or generally about living over there and how they do it. So that's one of the key factors our students actually learn from the environmental sustainability. That shapes up their mind. So when they put that in practice, it comes back to them. So absolutely. So, and also we cover up one factor about the sociology of the gastronomy field, the entire gastronomy about food, and the anthropology as to how it has been happening and what will happen in future. Because future careers, just the jobs are not yet been invented, and that's where I say that you don't know. That's why you need to understand the past, and that will design your future as well.
So it's the age of the web, the internet, the social media. So how does sustainability features as an online course, as a business and a profitable module, as an enterprise, not just financial profitability, but ethical profitability or nutritional profitability,
right?
How does that feature?
Two aspects to it. One, I'll talk about the young minds who tomorrow might become an entrepreneur. So we are coming up with a postgraduate diploma specifically in culinary entrepreneurship, which is an year and a half course, which would be actually designed to look at the sustainability factor. That program, of course, culinary cannot be taught in terms of online programs. But when you talk about sustainability, certain modules can be included within the program, which could be online courses. But again, what happens is learning online of anything will be more of an information gathering. But application of it will come in real life. So I feel online courses are a good idea as far as getting the information is concerned. But applicability of it will only come in when they do it real in reality. That's my view about it. And we are doing few of the courses for people to learn across different parts of the world as well as in India.